A very good morning to you. It's Resurrection Sunday, and I'm so glad you're joining us this very special Resurrection Sunday, where we're going to celebrate the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. A very good morning to every one of you from Cornerstone. A very good morning to every one of you from our Facebook family and whatever platform you're joining us. Saints, in heavenly armor, we're going to march through the land. Irrespective of what we're facing, irrespective of what's going on in the world and in our country, the battle belongs to the Lord. The victory belongs to you. Let's go and join the service. And I'm so glad we miss you so much, but I'm so glad we could connect like this on this platform. Join me as we now go into our main service. God bless you. Come on. Let me hear that. Lord, we give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Victory. Join me for the service and trust the Lord for the presence of Jesus to visit you in your home.
Saints, it's Resurrection Sunday.
a beautiful Sunday morning here in the presence of the Lord. And I'm so glad you're joining us. I'm so glad you're part of the service. We're going to go right into the word of the Lord, and I have a special word to share with you this precious, precious Resurrection Sunday morning. And again, thank you for joining us. Let's go to the word, and I've already showed this to you, and we've titled it The Strange Dream. The strange dream given to a young lady by the name of Claudia Procula. Claudia Procula. And we're going to look at this. Let's first go read that scripture. And it's mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew. Remember, Matthew was a tax collector. Matthew's occupation was a chartered accountant. Did you hear that? Matthew was a chartered accountant. Very meticulous, very orderly, very precise in what he did. And Matthew records for us in Matthew 27, 19. Let's read it together. And you can open up the scripture or follow me right now. Besides, verse number 19 says, while he was sitting, speaking of Pilate now, Pontius Pilate, and please watch our upload, the video that we did regarding his life. Pontius Pilate was sitting on the judgment seat. His wife sent word to him, have nothing to do with that righteous man, for I have suffered much because of him today in a dream. Did you read that? His wife sent word to him, Pilate, have nothing to do with that righteous man, speaking of Jesus, for I have suffered much. Did you hear that saying? Claudia Procula is the wife of Pontius Pilate, and she says, I have suffered much in a dream. Now, she begins to make intercession on behalf of Jesus. Who is this woman? Claudia Procula is actually Pontius Pilate's wife. And she appears only once, recorded for us in the Gospel of Matthew, where she makes intercession. She intercedes. She intercedes with Pilate on behalf of Jesus. And later on, we begin to find that she, her name is actually Claudia Procula. You could look at the historical evidence that clearly makes her name known to us. And the name is Claudia Procula in Latin. And she plays a role in various New Testament books, particularly the Apocrypha. And she acquires this name, Claudia Procula, and then she becomes venerated as a saint. Who are we talking about? Claudia Procula, Latin. Remember, the language in Rome is Latin. And Claudia is now known as Claudia Procula, a Latin name belonging to Rome. She is the wife of Pontius Pilate, the chief ruler on behalf of Rome in Jerusalem and in Israel. Now, saints, you need to understand some amazing things. This lady, Claudia Procula, is actually venerated as a saint by the Orthodox Church, in particular the Coptic Church and the Ethiopian Church, actually sainted Claudia Procula. This is the wife. Here's that scripture again, and I want to read it in the Amplified Version. And while he was seated on the judgment bench, his wife sent a message saying, have nothing to do with that just and upright man, for I had a painful experience today in a dream because of him. A painful experience in a dream because of him.
And Claudia is constantly insisting that her husband, Pilate, has nothing to do with Jesus. She did not want him to preside over that trial. She did want him to set Jesus free. Now, saints, this particular dream that she has, Saint Augustine of Hippo, a church father, a respected church father. You have Saint Jerome, a respected church father. You have the reformer who started the Reformation, one of them, John Calvin. Each one of them, Saint Augustine, Saint Jerome, John Calvin, each one of them argued and believed that the dream Claudia had was of divine origin. The dream that Claudia had actually came from God. Now please stay with me. While the court was still in session, this is another version, watch what it says. While the court was still in session, Pilate's wife sent him a message. Don't get mixed up in judging this noble man. Don't get mixed up in judging this noble man. She sends a message to Pilate. Why? Watch what the scripture says. I've just been through a long and troubled night. Why, Pastor Murray? Because of a dream about him. Did you see that? While the court was in session, while Pilate is at the praetorium presiding over the trial of Jesus, he receives a message from his wife, Claudia Procula. Have nothing to do with this Jesus. Don't get mixed up in judging this noble man, she says. I've just been through a long and troubled night because of a dream about him. Now, I want you to come a little closer and listen to this. We are never told what the dream is. Scripture does not tell us what the dream is. But after the dream, after this dream, Claudia Procula was convinced that Jesus was a just man, a noble man, a special person. And the dream causes Claudia to make intercession on behalf of Jesus. The dream that she has stirs her spirit that she begins to intercede on behalf of Jesus. She makes intercession. Did you hear that? The dream stirred something up inside of Claudia. Now, in the New Testament, the New Testament Apocrypha, the Apocrypha. Now, many of you in the Protestant church may not know what the Apocrypha is, but it is additional books found in the Catholic Bible. If you read the Catholic Bible, you'll find there's an additional number of books added, referred to as the Apocrypha. The Apocrypha has books like 1st and 2nd Maccabees, the book of the wisdom books, the book of Sirach, are all these books that make up the Apocrypha. In the apocryphal writings, additional writings, that's historical books, the most important text to feature Claudia Procula is the Gospel of Nicodemus, also called the Acts of Pilate, which expands a little more, giving us a little bit more information about Claudia Procula. In the Gospel of Nicodemus, Pilate's wife sends a message to Pilate, and the message is very detailed. Pilate then describes Procula as someone who is pious, someone who's actually practicing the Jewish religion. In some versions of the text, both Pilate and Procula are depicted as present at the crucifixion of Jesus. Now, if you're reading the apocryphal writings, you're going to discover that Claudia Procula, Pontius Pilate were actually at the crucifixion of Jesus. Because that dream she has changes her heart. That dream that God gave Claudia changes Pilate. Remember, Pilate wanted to save Jesus, not crucify him. I say this, I could share a whole lot of things with you, historical information that's absolutely amazing. But this is what I want to say to you this Resurrection Sunday. Claudia receives a dream. The dream changes her heart. She sees Jesus for who he is. God communicated to Claudia in a dream. God communicated a special message. History tells us. History and the Apocrypha, the book of Nicodemus, the Acts of Pilate, these books found in church history, they tell us that Claudia and Pilate actually get born again and saved. Now, many of you may be hearing this for the first time. That's the reason you need to get to the school of the Spirit. Claudia Procula, Pontius Pilate actually get born again. They receive Jesus as Lord and Savior. How did it happen? Through a dream. Strange dream. A mysterious dream. None of us know what the dream is about, except Claudia and except Pilate. And these two people historically get born again and saved. They receive Jesus as Lord. And the church has venerated both Claudia and Pilate. And in many churches, the Orthodox, the Ethiopian church, the Coptic church, actually venerate them as saints. Pastor, what does this have to do with me? It has everything to do with you, saints. During the season, I believe during this Passover season, during this Resurrection Sunday morning, while you are at home for this balance of these 21 days, God wants to visit you. Yes, you. And God is going to give you a dream. A dream about Jesus. I firmly believe that the resurrected Jesus, who has ascended to the Father, seated at his right hand, is longing to talk to you. God wants to communicate his heart to you. God wants to speak to you. Yes, lady, you want to hear the voice of the Lord? You are crying out for God to visit you. He will in a dream. He will in a dream. Sir, God is going to visit you in a dream. He's going to reveal his face to you in a dream. He's going to reveal his plans to you in a dream. He's going to give you ideas in a dream. He's going to give you thoughts in a dream. He's going to reveal things to you in a dream. If he did it for Claudia, he'll do it for you. If God visited Claudia Procula in a dream, he will visit you. And God has something to share with you. He has something to show you. And I believe, I sense that so strong in my heart. God's going to do it. What's going to happen in my dream, Pastor? God's going to give you plans. He's going to give you directions. He's going to give you ideas. How? In the dream. Direction is coming your way. How? In a dream. Plans are coming your way. How? In a dream. Ideas are coming your way. How? In a dream. This Passover season, you are going to break through. You are not going to break down. Did you hear that? This Passover season, you're going to break through. You're not going to break down. No, 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 no. The enemy cannot have any control over your life. He does not own you. Jesus purchased your salvation. Jesus purchased your life. And the people at home said, Amen. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a big God bless you. You are not going to break down. You are going to break through. This Passover season, come on, come on, come on, come on. Are you here at home with me? This Passover season, you will win the battle. You will not lose the fight. This Passover season, you will rise up healed. Healed. And sickness leaves your life in Jesus' name. This Passover season, you are passing over sickness. This Passover season, you are passing over death. Death has no hold. You will not die. No one in your family is going to die. You are not going to die, because Jesus, the resurrected Savior, is right there with you. And you say amen and give him a big God bless you. Come on. You are passing over death. Death has no hold on you. No hold on you. You are passing over unemployment. Those of you that are worried about your financial future. What's going to happen to my finances? What's going to happen to my provision? Pastor, how am I going to get through? You are passing over unemployment. You are passing over lack. You are passing over into health and healing. You are passing over from fear to faith. Oh, come on. God's going to visit you in a dream. He's going to speak to you in a dream. His word is going to come to you in a dream. Now stretch your hands towards me right now. Right now. Right now in Jesus' name. Open my eyes, Lord, please. Can I hear that? Open my eyes. Open my eyes. From that same folder, open my eyes. Now saints, I'm praying for you. Every one of you, come here a little closer, please. Every one of you. God's going to open your eyes. Why? The supernatural, my brother and sister, did not die. The supernatural power of God is not just in the old covenant. The supernatural power of God doesn't belong just to the book of Acts. The supernatural, the ministry of dreams, the ministry of dreams, 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 dreams. God's visiting you in dreams. He's going to visit you in a dream. He's going to reveal things to you in a dream. And I want you to believe them. Believe with me. Those of you that are believing the Lord for that dream, for God to speak to you in a dream, I want you to stretch your hands to me right now. Come on. Saints, he visited Claudia in a dream. He visited Joseph in a dream. He visited Abraham in a dream. He visited his saints in a dream. God's going to visit you in a dream. He visited Noah in a dream. He's always moving with dreams. And right now in Jesus' name, God by his Spirit is going to visit you. Father, in Jesus' name, this Resurrection Sunday, open the eyes of every person that is tuned in. Open the eyes of every person that is connected here right now in the service. And Lord, reveal Jesus. Reveal Jesus. Reveal your Son. Reveal your plans. Lord, every single person is trusting you for their lives. Believing you, Lord, for things to take place in their lives. Believing you for a breakthrough. Believing you for a miracle. I pray as they tuned in, the presence of Jesus himself will flow through this technology right into their homes. Tonight, wonderful Lord. Tonight, wonderful Lord. Tonight, wonderful Lord. Visit every person that's connected right now in a dream. Give them a plan for their lives. Show them things that you want to do in Jesus' mighty name. Our saints, God's going to visit you. Some of you are going to receive plans in a dream. Your future in a dream. What, Pastor, what am I going to do? God's going to show it to you in a dream. He visited Claudia, saint, in a dream. Noah in a dream. Abraham in a dream. Joseph in a dream. Daniel in a dream. He's going to visit you tonight. In a dream. Can I ask you to do something? I'm so sure of this. I'm going to ask you to share your dreams with us. The Lord, maybe you, not everything, but you say, Pastor, God did visit me. Please share your testimony with us, because I know he will visit you. And the people said, now you can lift your hands right where you are and say, Lord, open my ears. I want to hear Help me to listen. Let me hear you, everyone. We give you praise to reach. We want to see your Son in all his glory. We want to see Jesus in all his glory. Everything. Details, then just go visit the website cornerstonekzn.com and you're more than welcome. Remember, God will always cause you to prosper. No lack, no unemployment to those that are walking with Him. Why? We are in covenant with Him. Lord, we are in covenant with you. I'm a sower of seed. I'm a tither. The blessing of Abraham is over you, your household, your income, your employment. Poverty has no room in your life. Lack has no room in your life. Why? You are a sower of seed. And this particular season, this month of April, we receive your seed into this ministry in Jesus' name. God will prosper you. God will bless you abundantly. Father, I pray the blessing of Abraham, the blessing of Abraham over every seed sown, the blessing of Abraham over every tither. Wonderful Lord, protect every person's employment, protect that business. You that are owning businesses, God protects your business. Why? You're a sower of seed. His hand is over it. God protects your employment. God protects and blesses your income. So Lord, cover the seed that's sown. Everyone that's going to sow their seed today, bless them, I pray, abundantly. 100-fold blessing in Jesus' mighty name. And the people said, amen. And amen and amen. Now, saints, we are still on the lockdown. Thank you for being faithful in flattening the curve. And please remain safe. Please, I beg of you. Let's receive the blessing of the Lord this wonderful resurrection morning. And I'm so glad that you connect with us on this platform. Make sure you like. Make sure you comment. I'm going to talk to you. As soon as I'm done here, I'm going to chat to every one of you that's logging in and leaving a comment. I'm going to personally respond to every comment. Thank you for connecting. Thank you for liking. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for helping me minister the word of the Lord to your family, to your friends, to your social circle. I'm so glad. Let's receive the blessing of the Lord. It's Resurrection Sunday. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his glorious face shine upon thee. The Lord be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee. And the Lord God of our father Abraham, the Lord God of Isaac, the Lord God of Jacob, grant unto you and your household this Passover season abundant peace. This is your friend and brother, Mervyn Naidu, reminding you that the devil is a liar. Jesus is Lord, and you. more than a conqueror. God bless you.